name is Shifa Rakshit. I am in grade 8 and I study in James City International School. So today I am going to elaborate the term satellite. Topics to be covered are what is satellite and about the satellite. More about the satellite and uses of satellite, what is orbit and types of satellite. So first we'll see what is satellite. A satellite is a moon, planet or machine that orbits another planet, machine or moon. Likewise, Earth is a satellite because it orbits the Sun. Likewise, the moon is a satellite because it orbits the Earth. Usually, the term satellite refers to a machine that is launched into the space that revolves around Earth or another body in the space. These satellites are very useful for mankind nowadays because we are totally dependent on satellites. Internet is provided from satellite. For communication, satellites are used. For GPS tracking, satellites are used. And for many things, satellites are used. Nowadays, we are totally dependent on satellite because if the satellite will not there, then we will not be able to communicate, we will not be able to share something, and our life is totally dependent. Like we say, we are dependent on phones, but phones are dependent on satellites because the internet in that, the browsers, the Google and the all things in the phone are totally dependent on satellite. Next we have something more about satellite. Sputnik 1. Sputnik 1 was the first satellite to be launched in space. It was launched on October 4, 1957. And it was launched by Soviet Union. There are two types of satellite, man-made satellite and artificial satellites. As I have given you examples of moon and earth, they were not artificially made. They were naturally built from billions of years. But there are artificial satellites also which man made to launch into the space. And on the satellite we are dependent that are artificial satellites. We have uses of satellites. Satellites are used in communication which makes us connect to all the world. They are used in weather forecasting systems. Weather forecasting systems aware us about what's the weather of tomorrow and where to go. This system is very useful for army, militaries and navy. Satellites are used for GPS, global positioning system. So this GPS are used for finding the routes where we have to go and tracking the best position, best route for that. And they are used in transport instruments and passengers to the space to perform experiments. They are also used to calculate the amount of elements in space. They are also used to see whether the asteroids are there and to for science research. Scientists have to go where we can say astronomy. So in astronomy, we have information all about space. So how we have space, how we have information about space. Some scientists, particular scientists gone there, they have collected that information and then they give us. But these all are dependent on satellite because satellite gives scientists the information that the weather, the climate is clear around me and please come and take your research and go like this. So satellites are also used to give information of space to scientists. As I have told, the information about space, what's there in space, what's gonna hit that satellite, and about solar eclipse, lunar eclipse, they just all are given by satellites. Next we have, what are orbits? So on a particular path, the satellites revolve. Like Earth revolves around the Sun on a particular path, that is known as orbit. Moon revolves around the Earth on a particular path, that is orbit. So satellites also have orbit. They just revolve around the particular body on a particular speed and they just maintain their speed and path on their lifetime. So this an orbit is a regular repeating path that an object space takes around one another. So the object in space, while it can be asteroids and meteoroids, then asteroid belts which Jupiter and Venus has in between. So they have a repeating path. They are oscillating. So that is known as orbit. An object moves in an orbit is called a satellite. So whatever object that moves in an orbit, that is known as satellite. As Earth moves in an orbit, so that is known as satellite. And a moon is revolving around, so that is known as orbit. Next we have types of satellite. There are more types of satellite. That satellites are, there are three main types of satellite. There are many types of satellite, but the main satellite types of satellites are only three. First is low Earth orbit, second is medium Earth orbit, and third is geosynchronization Earth orbit. That is also known as geostationary orbit. Low Earth orbit is an orbit that is relatively close to Earth's surface. Like it is not far, but it is 100 km and could be less than 160 km above the Earth. That is really a short distance for a satellite. That is minimum distance is 160 km, but this distance should not be crossed downwards. So satellites in this orbit moves at a speed of 7.8 km per second. 7.8 km per second is the speed of this satellite. Every satellite speed is different, but it's per second. It revolves very fast. These satellites are used for communication, military recognition, spying and other imaging applications. Matlab, these satellites are used for spying, like these pictures which are given to militaries that this forest are there, mapping process and communication. For communication, the satellite speed should be at the maximum, because we have to communicate everywhere. And this is not one satellite who provides us. There are groups of satellite. Like we have this satellite, which is low Earth orbit satellite, which is used for communication, that have a collocation. You know about stars collision. So this have groups at a specific distance. They have groups around the Earth, and here we are standing. Above us, one satellite is there, and that satellite will not find the person whom we are calling. That satellite will provide our call to another satellite, and that satellite, if that satellite have person nearby, that's him, then only he is finding the satellite, or he will transfer that data to another satellite. Like this group of satellites work. Next we have medium Earth orbit. This medium Earth orbit is an orbit which is situated between low Earth orbit and geostationary Earth orbit. This we're gonna see afterwards, and this we have seen low Earth orbit now. It's used for communication. So medium Earth orbit is, it is at altitude of 2,000 to 35,000 km. So it is above the low Earth orbit and below the geostation. So here we have seen limited of low Earth orbit is 15,000 km. So about leading 5,000 km, here is 2,000 km to 35,000 km. So next we have this Earth orbit moves at a speed of 3.13 km per second. So this speed of the satellite is decreasing accordingly. So here we have 3.13 km per second. This medium Earth orbit speed is very less but it's per second, so we can say it's very less, but in space it's revolving very fast. This kind of satellites are used in global positioning system. They are little bit moving slow according to Earth orbit, Earth rotation, because the global positioning system requires stability. Like if the satellite will not be stable, so we will be finding different routes. So it has to be still on its place. Therefore, the speed is slow. Next, we have geostationary Earth orbit. Geostationary Earth orbit is an orbit which is situated above the medium Earth orbit. Matlab, it's above the 35,000 kilometers. So here its altitude is 35,786 kilometers. And the satellite in this orbit moves at a speed of 3.07 kilometer per second. So again here the speed is decreased because these satellites are used for tracking. These satellites are used for tracking, forecasting, atmospheric tracking and oceanography. So it is used for weather forecasting. And for weather forecasting, we need that satellite to be at one place, because if we rotate, then the atmosphere will be different. Then the pressure of the earth will be different. And this is also used for oceanography. What is oceanography? That oceanography is centrifugal force that moon orbit at a full moon night, and the tubes which are above the levels. So that is known as oceanography.